So, here I am in my hammock. Look at it. I can't imagine how stupid I was to trust Trump last year and support him. All the time lost. Besides, gone totally mental. Tomorrow, the senators are visiting him, so please do something about it. He's dangerous. I wonder what he's doing to Julian Assange. I think he's not intelligent enough for the job. There is a White House leak. There is someone brave who's reporting, and it's apparently the foreign policy is zero knowledge. He doesn't know the foreign policy. He has to look it up. He knows nothing about foreign policy, so he's dependent on what people tell him. I'm tired. I didn't sleep last night because I was chasing Redstone and earthquakes and harp. And how much time did I spend explaining that the Syria was fake attack? And it didn't take many sanctions. Because, here, angry White House staffer. But that's the former one. I will tell him. Look, angry White House staffer. The bombing of Syria accomplished nothing militarily, and that was by design. We coordinated with Russia and the target, all for show. Here. We get there. I wanted to have some nicer narrative, but I'm so tired of him. And the worst is that I was supporting him. I'm in my hammock, so it's a bit difficult to feel my heart. Hold the camera, please, open. See, there's something here. Angry White House staffer, that was the first account. Here. I work at the Trump White House. This is a disaster. Here. But, the bombing accomplished nothing. Militarily. All for sure. The total tragedy is Nikki Haley. Where is Nikki Haley? We'll just is thinking about suspending daily press briefings until the media learn to be nice. I think Nikki Haley was here. This one. The woman that's deciding about life in Syria. None good. I saw Nikki Haley on CNN tonight. Laughable how little she actually knows about what president thinks. You know, who is leading this country? You are controlling, you are the policeman of the world. You're bombing. You're killing people. You're killing people with harp. And then these primitives are going somewhere at the beginning is that he doesn't like his job and he should have never run. There's someone down there. I think he's I'm supporting him because I hate this Clinton. But maybe Hillary would be a bit more careful. He's like he can explode and not press the nuclear button. Yeah, I don't know. I don't really intend to live in war, and I don't want to see Syria hurt because Dr. Assad didn't do anything wrong. It's just stupid deep state. Here. This is at the damage control meeting about Melania. She's considering filing divorce papers. She hates this life. So if she hates this life, please leave this life and get Ron Paul or Ralph Nader or someone competent into the White House, because you're deciding about our life as well. Here, February 15. There is no glorification about of those first 100 days. Yeah. Given what I'm seeing here, I'm left with one option to save this nation. I'm going to start leaking everything. Direct message me if you're media. They are totally. They must be shocked. He doesn't have any charisma, presidential charisma. Must be awful. But yeah, that's the image. But he's damaging the country. He threw a Molotov on the. That was also somewhere in DC that the mob wasn't the best tactic to weapon to use in Afghanistan. But it was all to impress North Korea or China or whoever. I'm not a strategist. The problem around here with loyalty to the president is he isn't exactly the kind of inspiring leader you take a bullet for. Yeah, I can imagine that. You know, I really enjoyed his behavior when it was opposing Hillary, because I really hate the bitch. But he's treating all the people like that. He even got Trump instead. Even got Trump, that's another tragedy. Basically, you got dictators there. And all the time, Israel, get lost with it. I'm looking for this, where he's saying that he doesn't mean him. He doesn't want to be president. Here, February 6th. The president had been talking about how much nicer Mar-a-Lago is than the White House. Drives me nuts. It's a privilege to live here. Imagine, you put, he's a showman, he's a clown, and you put him in the White House, people. I wanted Rand Paul there. Please, put Rand Paul there. Where is the... We all think about the stories that we could have told. Here. It's difficult when the small stupid computer here. People ask me why I don't resign. If everyone here who was a decent human resigned, there'd be nothing left but blocked thirsty cycles. That's exactly. You gave the power to the bloodthirsty cycles there. Luckily there is someone a little bit holding, trying to do something about it. I need to find that he doesn't want to be president. Hi, president gets a pedicure and manicure once a week, and his girl is flown from New York City. I'm laying in a very not comfortable position to say me. Here. February 2nd. Is this all gonna open? Right. I told you, the president doesn't prepare for phone calls. So he's calling with some leaders, and he's doing it because he's doing it the way he was always running his company. But this is not a company. This is the United States of America. And you know, I don't give a damn what you're doing inside, but you're controlling us, our lives. Here, February 1. Thank you for the support. You guys are the only thing keeping me going. But you know, I can feel a bit how he is. He doesn't realize it. He's a dangerous figure. I'm so tired. Oh, let's find it. Oh, here. January 27. January 27. I work at the White House. For how long is anyone's guess? We are all thinking of quitting. January 27th. There are two accounts. First it was angry White House staffer, and now angrier. Just around the Syria strikes. I looked in on her. I don't know who it is, but she's very intelligent. So now we're gonna go to angry. Angrier. And now we're going to the angrier. So this is on this first version. There's a lot of information, but to understand how it feels there, how he's making his decisions, how he's all the time only focusing on his ratings and what people think about him, if the media are very nice about him. The company said, this shouldn't be the president. So now there are blogs. This brave patriot started writing a blog, and I'm here, new blog post, and that's where it's about the foreign policy. Okay, we have to finish. I'm afraid it's 21 minutes, so it's too much. Question about foreign policy. Question, who's making decisions here? How are decisions actually made in the White House? Alright, so many flip-flops and walk back. What are the real policies, or is it as tricky as it seems? As Bannon's influence varies, there is actually a policy-centric approach that is developing, especially on foreign policy. McMaster seems to have a really solid grasp on the NSC, and voters is increasingly listening to him and Mattis, which is great for the country because he, voters, has exactly zero foreign policy experience. Or much of an opinion beyond talking points, honestly. Zero policy experience. Okay. I have to stop because probably 22 minutes, 23 seconds, it could be too long for YouTube. So, please, tomorrow, senator. Please stop him taking some stupid action against Korea. North Korea. There was no problem with North Korea. No escalating problem with North Korea. Under Obama, whom he... I hated Clinton. But Obama was the travesty of... So I have to finish. Bye.